Thank you, everyone, for coming. It's great to see alumni, friends, faculty, staff, students, and other wonderful members of the Rose Holman family here. Your attendance reflects the true spirit of homecoming. My name is Bill Finolio, and I'm chairman of the Board of Trustees of Rose Holman Institute of Technology. Shortly before commencement last May, I received a letter from the leadership of the graduating class with a request. They thought it appropriate to name this Student Innovation Center after Matt Branham, the man whose idea was to craft and construct this facility so students could collaborate together on competition teams in one spot instead of various places across campus and off campus. As all of you know, we lost Matt suddenly last April. The Board of Trustees felt this would be a fitting tribute to the life and the legacy of Matt Branham, and as a result, the trustees voted with unanimous support to name this facility the Branham Innovation Center. To commemorate this naming, I'd like to begin our program by introducing President Rob Koontz. Rob?
We have a number of members of our Board of Trustees here today who I'd like to acknowledge their attendance by just waving, giving us a wave. I'm not sure exactly who all is here today, but if you're a Board of Trustee member, please wave. I'd also like to acknowledge several members of Matt's family who are with us here today. Thank you very much for attending. Before the official ceremony, I'd like to give you a little background on this outstanding facility and also share a couple of surprises. Exactly 1 year ago, Matt Branham was standing at this podium filled with pride, excited to be announcing the opening of the new Student Innovation Center. As a Rose Holman alumnus and civil engineer, starting his career at UPS, Matt built a lot of big garages, some of the biggest garages in America. However, he had never built one with such fun and an exciting purpose as this one. During the ceremony last year, the crowd clapped to see America's great physicist and futurist, Michio Kaku, being chauffeured to the stage in Rose's eco car. Dr. Kaku spoke of the wonderful education he found happening on this campus. He spoke about how he saw innovation and creativity being nurtured instead of being squashed by rote learning. He said Rose was what an education should be. Ironically, Dr. Kaku, a futurist, spoke of the present, and it was Matt who spoke of the future. Matt described his vision for this place. He imagined a big garage where students could work late into the night tinkering with team projects, tweaking engines, welding frames, turning wrenches, shaping their dreams to test them, break them, race them, win, and tear them down and try something new. This is where the rubber literally meets the road, where theory turns into practice, where conflicting ideas get debated and tested, where friendships are formed and respect is earned. In the beginning, it was Matt who insisted there be no walls between the teams. He wanted open bays where tools could be shared and ideas could flow freely. As Trustee David Hanum said in his concluding remarks at that event, don't ever forget this is a big garage, and really cool things happen in garages. Today, there are some really cool things happening here. In the East Bay, we have students working on EcoCar. With EcoCar 1, our team developed a vehicle that could get 45 miles per gallon. Fast forward 1 year, from the hundreds of colleges and universities who applied to compete in EcoCar 2, Rose Holman's team was chosen as only one of 15 elite teams in North America. We have one of the only two teams staffed by undergraduate students. I'm pleased and excited today to announce that the car for this next competition arrived this week. And here it is. I need a drum roll. Thank you. our students will be tearing apart this brand-new 2013 Chevy Malibu Hybrid, throwing away parts, adding new parts, testing and modeling ideas, and transforming this production vehicle into something brand-new, something the world has never seen before. It will be a car that gets better gas mileage, even with better performance, than the last. But EcoCar is only the start of what's happening in this big garage. Going down the line of bays from east to west, we have Rose Grand Prix Engineering. In only their second year of competition in open-wheel race car design program, our team moved up from 55th out of 105 teams in their first competition to 15th place in only their second competition. And we're looking forward to a terrific 2013. Rose Efficient Vehicle has developed a car that is placed as high as third at the Shell Eco Marathon and has made astounding runs of over 1,800 miles per gallon. Wouldn't that be great for the family SUV?
Second.
Team Rose Motorsports is a classic racing program for students who like to go really fast. Our motorsports roots are deep at Rose Hallman, and it's more than just a pastime for us. We take pride in the Hallman of our name, and it's a constant inspiration for us to go faster. In another bay, the concrete canoe is under construction by civil engineers. In this program, the teams learn about concrete modeling, stress, team dynamics, design, presentation skills, and how to paddle as fast as possible. The human-powered vehicle has dominated national competitions for several years, developing innovative designs that always show up a year or so later on other college teams. And the e-car isn't the only surprise today. This year, we have cleared the West Bay of this facility to become the new home for the Rose Robotics team. It's my pleasure to make another very special announcement, an announcement that is great for Rose as a campus and great for the businesses of our larger Terre Haute and Vigo County communities, and most importantly, an announcement that will inspire thousands of high school students who hope to be future scientists and engineers. It's my great pleasure to announce to you today that 2013 will be the year of robotics at Rose Hallman as we become a regional site for the international first robotics competitions. Rose Robotics is the premier international high school robotics competition. It will bring more than 100 teams of top high school science, technology, engineering, and mathematics students to Rose for 2 days of competition over our spring break in 2013. We anticipate as many as 5,000 people, competitors, spectators, parents, coaches, and judges to invade Terre Haute that weekend. Teams come from a dozen states and several foreign countries. And of course, our own admissions representatives will be on hand to take applications from some of the brightest minds in the country. Here today to talk a little about that event is our own Professor Carlotta Berry, head of our robotics minor. Carlotta.
Thank you, Rob. Thank you so much. We are so excited about the first robotics competition that will be here next year. It's going to be something like you have never seen before in your life. It's not just robots competing, it's students excited about science, engineering, and math. And I am just so honored. They have been trying to get Rose Hallman for a long time, and we are not going to disappoint. I want everyone to please come back. We actually have some of the first teams here today. There's a first Lego League right here in the front, and that's Team Storm. They're going to be inside showing off their little robot. And the other team is actually inside getting set up, and that's going to be the high school team. And there's going to be 50 of those here next April. And now I would also like to call up Clint Ott. He's a sophomore in mechanical engineering here at Rose Hallman, and he's a first alum, and he was on Team 1730. And he wants to talk a little bit about what first meant to him and how that kind of framed his decision to pursue science and engineering as well as come to Rose Hallman. Thank you.
So like she said, my name is Clint Ott. I am a sophomore mechanical engineering student here. I'm originally from Kansas City, Missouri, where I was part of Team 1730 for 3 years while I was in high school. And I know a lot of you might not necessarily be familiar with what FIRST is all about, but it's a great program that really gets high school students excited about science, technology, engineering, and math. It does this so well by putting high school students together with professional engineers solving real-world engineering problems. Through doing this, you get a lot of different experiences and you learn a lot of new things. Some of the things you learn are more technical, like, you know, finding distress in a shaft on a motor, or, you know, learning how to weld or manufacture parts. But then, more importantly, you gain a lot of non-technical skills that you can't really get anywhere else. You learn a lot about teamwork, a lot about innovation, a lot about leadership. And FIRST is one of the best programs I've seen for getting students not only prepared for college, but also prepared for working out in the engineering community. I was really excited when I heard there was school. We do a lot of hands-on learning, and I think it'd be a really good fit for you if you come out and visit. I came out, visited, fell in love with it, and once I figured out how to get here, I was able to attend. I'm hoping that through this regional, we can all work together to get a lot more stories like mine, get a lot new innovative kids here at Rose Holman, and I hope you guys all do get to come back. It's a great experience. It's a lot of fun, and I think it's a great opportunity. Thank you.
Nice job, Clint. We'll all mark our calendars for next spring break, 2013. FIRST Robotics might not have been possible without this big garage as a site for robot repairs and machining, which is pretty extensive for one of those events. This exciting new and existing activities in this collaborative space are exactly the types of things that Matt envisioned just a couple of years ago. It is with great honor that I stand before you today and announce the naming of this building, the Branham Innovation Center. Matt, your vision for this center of innovation continues to be strong and is growing. And we know that your inspiration will be here whenever the lights are burning at 3 a.m. as students continue to work. When we hear the roar of an engine being pushed through its RPM range, when we hear a student cheering on his fellow teammates to victory in the faster competitions around the world. In just short, it is euphoria for many of our students just like Matt. And so it is a fitting tribute that the Branham name will forever be synonymous with innovation on our campus. This plaque, which will hang on the wall of the Branham Innovation Center, reads as follows. In memory and appreciation for the Branham Innovation Center, September 22, 2012, Matt Branham, Class of 79, President 2009 through 2012, presented by Rose Holman Institute of Technology and its Board of Trustees. At this time, I'd like to ask the members of Matt's family to join us at the sign for an unveiling. And while they're moving to the sign, we're going to need the crowd's help to count down. So get ready. That concludes our naming ceremony for the Branham Innovation Center. Jason couldn't make it today, will be representing our FIRST Robotics Organizing Committee, as well as the EcoCar teammates, will be on hand in the facility and out here to answer any questions you might have. Thank you so much for joining us today. Thank you.